What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network, where we continue our discussion on how to use tools that liberate mankind and that protect your privacy. And among others, there is, of course, the Wasabi wallet, which yesterday we have showed you why this is important and how to easily install this tool of self-defense. Now, upon first install and running the software, it is, of course, synchronizing to the Bitcoin network, which might take a bit of time. But what is actually happening here in the background? Well, first of all, it is everything running over Tor here. So all your information packages are being transmitted, not unencrypted over the ClearNet, but encrypted with end-to-end encryption and onion routing packages over the Tor network. You're also, though, connected to peers on the Bitcoin network, 8 of them by default, from which you get all the current transactions that are not yet confirmed in the blockchain, the memory pool. Though further, and very interestingly, you are downloading filters, and these are specifically Golem Rice filters, which is an upgrade to the way that historically SPV light clients have connected to the Bitcoin network. Initially, these Bloom filters were used so that you would send a Bloom filter of all your addresses that you are interested in to individual nodes. And these would check which blocks contain or with the addresses that you are interested in. But this has, of course, the downside that the node knows which specific address you're interested in. However, Wasabi, as we said yesterday, uses state-of-the-art operational security, and that is, among many other points, also this neutrino-style light client. And it basically flips around the concept of Bloom filters, where the node generates a Bloom filter of all the addresses that are in every block. And then the full node sends to you, the SPV node, this Bloom filter. And this is what we are downloading right now, a list of all the Bloom filters that we might be interested in. And now that we have these filters on our hardware, we can check which blocks contain addresses that we are interested in. And this also then means that we can locally verify which blocks we might be interested in. And then from a completely separate node, we can download this specific block. And thus, we will not leak which specific addresses we are interested in, but only which blocks we are interested in. And this, of course, increases the anonymity set immensely from the get-go. So already you see that Wasabi is already in the initial synchronization process tuned to protect your privacy on every level. And this is a theme which we will see throughout this entire wallet. And join me tomorrow, where we will continue exploring the user interface and a step-by-step guide on how to use this tool, which is the Wasabi wallet. Piers, thank you very much for joining me, and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.